It is officially the worst nuclear disaster in history, a complete meltdown at the Chernobyl plant back in 1986. And even though Japanese officials say that their situation at their plant is not that bad, one Chernobyl survivor says residents should not take any chances. They need to leave now. That survivor, Simon Swerdlow, joins us live right now from Miami. Good morning to you, Simon.
Good morning, sir. Thanks for having me here.
It's great to have you as well. You were 8 years old at the time of Chernobyl, and what do you remember the government telling your family about how bad it was?
The government never said really anything. I remember that I was 8 years old, just like you said, but I remember my parents and everybody is around wondering why government is really keeping it a secret. It's not...
Sure.
You know, and we lived right by the station. We all knew something that was going on. But even on the national TV, they said that everything is okay. You just relax.
Right.
It's a minor accident. Nothing is happening.
Just a minor accident. Of course, through time then, it was determined that something bad had happened there. Tell me about the casket money that the government offered people who lived around there.
Later on, when they, you know, realized that a lot of really more cemeteries than anything were built around, and even my classmates, little kids, they were passing away, and we saw this happening. Government was giving away something called casket money for people to buy some additional vitamins, or this is what they referred to. I mean, they didn't call it, the people referred to it as
right.
a casket money.
Sure. Now, Simon, we've got to point out that what happened in Chernobyl was the worst nuclear disaster we've had in the, you know, while manufacturing electricity on the planet. And they say that what's going on right now in Japan is not nearly that bad. There has been a release of some radioactive vapor and stuff like that, but they're making it sound not so bad. But you say the people of Japan who live around that reactor, those reactors, need to do what?
Basically, I would think that they would need to leave, because even the government might not necessarily, or anybody might necessarily estimate the consequences when you're dealing with something as dangerous. It's like an invisible enemy. It's not that it's shooting at you. You don't know where and how to expect it. You don't know how it's going to get to you. So you better leave instead of really taking chances with your own health and health of your family.
Yeah, I can understand why you would not have trusted the Russian government, but you don't think that the people around there should trust the Japanese government either?
I think they should totally trust the government. I mean, the government has been very welcoming in terms of the international help. I'm sure they've learned their lessons from back from 25 years from Chernobyl. I don't say that they shouldn't trust the government. It's difficult to take chances again when you're dealing with something as dangerous as radiation.
Absolutely.
So it's more than just trusting the government. It's just you're playing with your own health, which you don't necessarily want to do.